Hello. Today I'm going to be telling you how to locate game files and save files for all your favorite games. Now, the first instinct that you should have, as somebody who works with computers, is to simply follow the shortcut. This is something you may or may not know, but if you click a shortcut, a Windows shortcut, and you right-click, you'll be given this option to open a file location. This will actually take you to the folder with the executable that your shortcut is linking to, or whatever other type of file it is a shortcut to. However, this often won't work. So, for example, I have Undertale installed through Steam, and you can see I right-click it and that option isn't there. And that's actually because, as you can see here, the shortcuts for Steam games are actually just opening URLs, and that redirects automatically through Steam to open the game indirectly. It's not actually directly pointing to an executable file on your disk, so you can't just follow it like that. And it's the same story with games that are installed through Epic, although this URL is perhaps a tad longer. And now, of course, your next question is going to be, well, how do I open games that are installed on Steam or through Epic? Steam, the procedure is quite simple. You right-click your game, you go to Properties. Next, you navigate to this section called Local Files. Click on Browse, and it will open File Explorer to the relevant directory. And you can see there's my data.win file. You can also manually navigate it by going to Program Files, x86. It might be in a different folder, but once you get to Steam, the actual program directory for Steam, it'll be all the same. Then you go to Steam Apps. Most of them will be in common. You might see them elsewhere, but that's unlikely. And then all of my games are here. And if I open up Undertale, I go to the same folder that I would have gone to anyways. Epic is also fairly straightforward, so if I load up Epic really quickly. And you can see if I try to install a new game, it'll give me a folder that it installs to. You can install Epic games actually to multiple folders on the same computer, so they may not all be in the same place if you did that while you were installing them. And all you have to do is go to Browse in this prompt, and you will see, oh hey, there's all of my games. Well, at least the game folders. It won't show me the individual files when I do it through that prompt, but they'll be there if I open it just in File Explorer, and which I'll demonstrate quickly now. So Epic Games actually just installs to Program Files on Windows. And you can see everything is here. Now your next question is probably, how do I find the save files? Because often save files aren't actually in the same folder as the games themselves. So if I go to, one common place they'll be is in My Games. This is very, very common on Windows for where they'll put the save file. There's also the less common location of saved games, which will be under your user in Windows. And as you can see, only one game I have ever installed on this computer has ever used this directory to store to. Lastly, and this one is actually a lot more common, is to store saved games to AppData. And AppData, this is important to know. You can see that this file icon is looking a little bit grayed out. That's actually because AppData is a hidden file. What that means is that it won't be shown to you by default. It'll be there, but it will just be invisible because it's not really meant to be tampered with by a standard user. So in order to enable that, you have to go to View, and you have to make sure that this checkbox called Hidden Items is checked, or else it will be invisible to you. And you can quickly navigate to AppData by typing in this short code to your search bar, and it will automatically take you to AppData, or it's specifically the roaming AppData. And from there you can usually find most of your save files. The three folders actually have slightly different purposes. A save file for a game can be in any one of them, but the basic gist is that local is stuff meant to stay on one specific machine, the specific computer. Roaming is data that's meant to move around with your user profile across multiple computers, and local low is like local, but it's meant to be more for low level stuff. And you'll find game files in all three, so be sure to look around. Usually, the file that you're looking for is going to have the name of either the game that you're modifying, for example, Squad here, or the studio that made it, like Dodge Roll, which made Enter the Gungeon. Just random examples. Anyways, that's the full tutorial. I hope that that was of some use to you. If you gained something from it, please like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And I hope you have a good day.